I am back. It has been some time since I have been on YouTube or uploaded a YouTube video. I never stopped watching YouTube, so don't get the misconstrued. But as far as me and my videos go, it has been some time. I can admit I kind of got a little discouraged because it's really hard getting subscribers and getting people to view your videos and different things. But I know that this is something that I should be doing, so it's a must that I get back to it. And I know the title of this video probably threw you off. Yes, I meant what I said, divorce him, sis. So basically, this is not particularly for married people to go get a divorce. I have no authority to walk around telling married people to go get divorces. This is particularly about soul ties. It's a problem when you are in a relationship with someone else, but you think about someone else or a ex or whatever. See, the thing is, we'll break up with people, but we don't break up with people. And the thing is, a lot of times our souls are still tied to people that they should not be tied to. First of all, a soul tie is a link that connects the soul to another person. But the thing is, soul ties were originally supposed to be for married people to help the connection, you know, physical connection, you know, mental connection. The reason for a soul tie is to help marriage. It's not for single people. But I, and you know, many of you had sex before marriage, so therefore we get soul ties. So the thing is, you know, God has really been dealing with me, and even since I've been married, I've had to rid myself of past soul ties. God has taken me back through relationships that I was in, you know, long before my husband, and had me to kind of forgive those people. Because what you do is you carry that over into the person that you call to be with, if you don't deal with those things, and then it brings in more problems. So basically, I wanted to just talk with you guys about divorcing anybody that you are not called to be with, anybody that is, you know, anybody that is bad for you, anybody that is not in God's will to stay in your life. So there are signs as far as how you would know whether or not you have soul ties or not. And a couple of those signs are, I took notes because this is like huge, and I just didn't want to leave anything out. You still feel connected to, one sign is you still feel connected to this person, or, you know, you may have numerous soul ties. You still feel connected to these people, even though it's been some time since you've been intimate with them. And you can also have soul ties just from emotional connection too. Don't get it wrong. And either way it go, you need to break it. So, another way, you know, you kind of feel like you're in love in a sense. And it may not necessarily be love, but like I said, a soul tie is something that connects your soul. So it'll have you thinking, I'm in love, or I feel these particular feelings about this person. And it's really, you know, it's an illusion in a sense, because your soul is tied to them. Technically, when your soul is tied to someone, you are married. That's hence the title, divorce him, sis. And this could go for men too, divorce her. All of a sudden, when you see this person or these people, you get these eerie feelings, you know, like it take you back to when you was with them. And I don't care how close you were to this person, when you come in contact with them, when it comes to below the belt, you shouldn't be feeling all horny and aroused. You shouldn't be feeling like, oh man, you know what I'm saying? I need to get back up with them. Because the past is the past. The past should be left in the past. If this person is not supposed to be a part of your life, once you recognize the signs and you realize, hey, yes, I do have some ungodly soul ties or a ungodly soul tie. So now what you want to do is repent. And repenting is not saying, God, I'm sorry, and going back and doing the same thing. Repentance is not only in you speaking or renouncing that covenant. It is also your actions going against the flesh. Not going with the flesh. Not going back to doing whatever it was that you did. Whether there was emotional, like I said, emotional soul tie, or it was from a sexual soul tie. So then you need to, once you repent, you then need to forgive this person of any wrong that they may have done to you. If you were in a relationship, they dogged you, they cheated you, you know, whatever it is that they may have done wrong to you that you may still be holding on, you want to forgive them. Then you want to renounce the covenant. You don't want any covenants within your life that are not of God. So you need to get rid of pictures. You need to get rid of text messages, the phone number. You may need to block them if you know that if they call, you're going to come running. So you want to get rid of any gifts, whatever it is. You may not be able to listen to particular songs anymore because it reminds you of this person. Last but not least, you want to pray. And you may need to continue praying because sometimes God will just take something away and sometimes it takes time. But one thing you want to do is continue to pray. Two things you want to do. Continue to pray and stay in your word. Read up about soul ties. Find out how you cannot fall back into that situation again. How you cannot fall into temptation again. And this video is for people who are tired of ungodly connections, because ungodly connections keep you away from what God has in store for you. This is not for people who are okay with having sex, or, you know, and if that is the case and you happen to get a hold to this video, I pray that it breaks every ungodly connection, or it makes you want to break every ungodly connection. So I didn't want this video to be too long, but I'm here if anybody wants to talk, if you want to DM me, if you want to leave a comment. I'll answer your questions. I'll help you in the best way I can. I'll pray with you, whatever the case may be. But right now, I'm going to lead us out in prayer. So, Heavenly Father, we just thank you right now for the opportunity, Lord God. We ask that you have your way with every listener, every follower, Lord, every subscriber, Lord God. We ask that you reach them right now wherever they are, Lord God. We ask that you get to the depths of their heart, Lord God. Ask that you show them how they got in this situation and help them to not get back into this situation, Lord God. We thank you right now, God. We thank you right now, Lord God. We thank you right now, Lord God, that they'll repent and turn from their ways, Lord God. We ask that right now you just break every ungodly soul tie that is connected to anybody who's watching this, Lord God. We ask that you just have your way right now, Lord God. Ask that they just turn from their ways, Lord God. Ask that they be a leader, Lord God. A leader and not a follower, Lord God. That they help lead people towards you, Lord God. That they help lead others out of temptation, Lord God. We just thank you right now, Lord God. We thank you right now for everything you have in store for their destinies right now over their lives, Lord God. We thank you right now that generational curses are broken, Lord God. We thank you right now that their kids and their children's children won't have to make these same mistakes, Lord God. We thank you right now, Lord God. We thank you right now for them giving birth to children who will marry their spouses and then lose their virginity, Lord God. We thank you right now, Lord God, for the chains being broken right now, Lord God. We thank you right now, Lord God. I ask that you send everybody to this message, Lord God, that needs to receive it, Lord God. We just thank you right now, Lord God. We thank you right now, Lord God. It's in your name we pray. Amen. As always, you guys, like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned for what I have in store for you guys. Everything you want and need, that good love and protection, make me a solution.